Hello, and welcome to The Works. I'm Ben Che.
And I'm Ben Pelletier. Thanks to the gradual relaxation of social distancing rules and COVID restrictions in venues, and to the return of Art Basel Hong Kong and Art Central, the city's art lovers have, in the past couple of weeks, once again had a chance to encounter a wide range of new works from both local and international artists.
Although inbound travelers don't have to spend quite as much time in quarantine as they did over the past 2 years, COVID-related restrictions still had some effect on both art fairs. Both were scaled down compared to the 2019 editions, partly for logistic reasons and partly because fewer collectors from the mainland and the rest of the world were expected to attend.
This year, as last, the Hong Kong Convention and Exhibition Centre was the primary exhibition venue for both Art Basel Hong Kong and Art Central. 130 galleries from 28 countries and territories took part in Art Basel, a significant increase from last year's 104. 15 were newcomers. This year also marked the second edition of the fair's hybrid art show, providing live streaming of events and walkthroughs, online viewing rooms, and shared booths for overseas exhibitors. Overseas galleries were also again offered the opportunity, first tried last year, to set up satellite booths at which they could present their own curator exhibition, staffed by a local representative.
In the way that most people would just assume, oh, the galleries are not here, they're sending their artworks, so possibly, you know, they'll play it quite safe. But I'm pleasantly surprised because I feel that there's so much for me to learn, and I think that's a wonderful sense of being able to discover. And I think they're doing quite well. If you look around between first day to now, some of the satellite booths have actually changed the works, so which means it's a good sign, meaning that works are selling.
Many international and mid-sized galleries report stronger sales this year. White Cube sold 7 pieces on the first day for a total of $1.3 million. House and Worth sold 11 works on the VIP day, including a George Condo painting that went for nearly $2.7 million. The apparent upswing is in line with the findings of the Art Market Report 2022, published in March by Art Basel and UBS. The report says that sales in the global art market rebounded strongly last year after a significant drop-off in 2020. Throughout 2021, total sales value had increased to $65.1 billion, surpassing the pre-pandemic levels in 2019. Online sales played an important role.
It was amazing when you looked at the figures for 2020 when COVID was really coming on strong. You know, the it was a huge drop in sales overall, but online sales, the value of online sales actually doubled. So it went from around 6 billion to 12.4 billion, which was its biggest ever level, and doubled in value from 2019, despite the fact that everything else was kind of falling. That component kept on rising. People are going to be a little bit more wary of going to every single event, but the ones they go to, I think they're going to take a little bit more seriously. And that is, it's not just COVID. It's the ideas of sustainability and not wanting to travel every single week or month to a new event, just focusing on the ones that are quite specific to you and that you value and you get the most returns from.
75 out of the 130 galleries participating, up from 57 last year, established their presence via satellite booth. 11 overseas exhibitors sent their own teams to Hong Kong. One of them is Nanzuka, a Tokyo-based contemporary gallery that focuses on underground pop art. Founder Shinzu Nanzuka says that throughout the years, he's been seeing a much younger demographic and many new faces collecting art.
I met with many new generations now from over the world, but they are using SNS, and we are communicating each other directly in very fast speed. Their decision is very fast. They are very familiar to decide their purchase only in JPEG, in the photo. I opened my gallery in 2005, and I represent many Japanese, those kind of like a pop underground artists. They are working for like magazines or TV commercials and designs. So that's why they are not recognized as fine artists in Japan. And now I think my gallery program became a kind of trend. So that's why it's not it didn't happen from the beginning. It just changed. Yeah.
Though the international presence was still sparser than in past years, and crowds on some days were thinner, this did give local galleries and artists more opportunities to make a splash. Blind Spot Gallery present a mix of emerging, mid-career, and fairly well-established local artists.
We've been confined in Hong Kong. The lack of traveling brings our attention to the local art scene. Also, indirect reason includes logistic challenges. It's been quite difficult and costly to transport artworks between Hong Kong and China, if possible at all. The Blind Spot have been showing more young Hong Kong local artists because we are a homegrown gallery, and then I'm also from here. So it's been, I always feel very close to showing Hong Kong artists, especially the younger ones. The most talked about one recently has been Xin Wai Kin, who has been shortlisted for the Turner Prize. Angela Su, who is currently representing Hong Kong in a Venice Biennial. When I started the gallery, it was mainly expat buying, and then I see a growing community of Hong Kong Chinese collectors. And this is a market we want to focus on and continue to groom.
Two floors above the Art Basel Hong Kong exhibition, Art Central featured 52 galleries, more than 20 of which were taking part for the first time. The presentations were divided into three sections: Chongqing Central Galleries, Huawei Created Booths, and Tok Tok Solo Presentations. And there was a strong emphasis on Hong Kong artists.
We've created a special area of the fair this year called Made in Hong Kong, giving unrepresented Hong Kong artists the opportunity to have their works displayed at the fair. We had some 650 applications, and we've ended up with 65 works from 40 different artists. I think it puts them on a platform. And even though not everybody can travel in, we'll be watching what happens in Hong Kong this week.
Hong Kong-based Touch Gallery was one of those joining the fair for the first time. It showcased works by three local artists, Sarah Tse, Silly Cheung, and William Lim, as well as Japanese artist Ogata Kamio.
We can do a lot of exhibitions, but because the rent is very high, so we think we want to get the things we get to give to it, so more people can know it or collect its works, that kind of idea. 這兩年的疫情令到 local 就更加可以崛起，因為多咗人去買 local artist 嘅嘢啦，咁佢哋又變得更加勤奮同投入啦，咁變咗佢哋更加專注嘅時候個水準又提高咗，咁佢提高咗個 collector 又買多咗，所以咧其實一個循環係好好嘅事咯。因為呢個港口封閉咗，所以啲錢就流翻曬喺呢個 local 度使咗出嚟啦。咁所以未來我諗要努力啲咯，即係 Hong Kong artist 即係真係把握住呢個機會做得最好，令佢哋變成佢哋長久可以支持嘅 artist。Despite
uncertainties about COVID-related policies, travel restrictions, higher shipping costs, and other possible delays, some overseas galleries still returned.
Shipping cost is one of the biggest things that actually affected our decision. It has doubled in price. And also the fact that Hong Kong has quarantined made it really difficult for a lot of the staffs to come over to Hong Kong, actually. Our last experience from last year was amazing, and it's really showing that Korean art is getting more and more popular this year. So that's the reason why we came back.
like at Basel, Hong Kong, Art Central featured other related programs such as talks and performances. Also, for the second year, finalists competing for the Sovereign Asian Art Prize were on display. This year's winner of the grand prize is Asin Savagari from Iran. 5 of the 30 finalists are from Hong Kong. One is Chris Cheung with his work, The Book of Ashes.
咁喺張紙仔好細張嘅紙仔入面咧，寫一啲嘅字句啦。咁然後將呢啲説話咧，就會我哋擺入呢個容器入邊咧，佢會有一個 burning ceremony 嘅。咁然後呢個 box 裏面嘅灰燼咧，其實就係一個好似 collectively 嘅一個意念，或者剩低落嚟想講嘅説話。其實希望透過呢個作品，佢可以抒發到一啲嘅想法。佢哋好似覺得燒嗰刻咧，好似有一啲嘢釋放咗出嚟咁樣。 因為其實場地咧嘅限制咧，我自己就做咗一個好似 vapor 嘅裝置，去營造翻個本身個藝術個概念咯。有一個展覽嘅機會咧，就可以 collect 到唔同嘅人嘅一啲 message。呢件作品唔單單只屬於我，係每一個參與嘅人嘅一種結晶品嚟。Welcome
back. As we saw earlier in the show, there was enthusiastic participation from local galleries, collectors, and artists in both Art Basel Hong Kong and Art Central this year. And their enthusiasm was shared by the public. Tickets sold out fast.
Apart from giving galleries a chance to present and sell artworks, both fairs collaborate with art and cultural institutions in organizing talks and programs to highlight individual artists and engage with the public. The two fairs might be over for this year, but there are still many ongoing cultural events and a lot of homegrown artistic talent for us to keep an eye on.
Outside the large hall holding Art Basel Hong Kong's main gallery presentations were booths set up by its cultural partners offering parallel programming such as Asia Society Hong Kong Centre, the Asia Art Archive, Hong Kong Art Centre, and art spaces such as 1A Space and Parasite. Parasites present a solo exhibition and newly commissioned work by Hong Kong artist Benny Toh, a recent graduate of the Hong Kong Art School and a recipient of a Bachelor of Arts degree in ceramics from Australia's RMIT University.
So, building on our established practice from before, we always try to, through the booth presentation, to support a local artist, an emerging artist, whose practice might be easily oversight by the fair presentation. So, for example, for ceramic practice, very often, maybe you will see one or two works in a group setting in the fair, but actually, very often, it is rarely to see a ceramic-based artist who have a solo presentation in the booth.
Also, as a same generation with the artist, we think that there are lots of common grounds in his work. So this is also interesting to show the like pop culture and show it as a mixture with contemporary art.
Toh likes to combine animate and manga, often referencing Asian mythology and religions. In the exhibition, Dimensional Civilization Archaeology Project 2.0, he expanded his ceramics practice to include an 8-bit video game in which viewers can excavate digital forms of his works.
咁2.0呢個 project 咧，其實主要係因為 Parasite 委託我去合作，就係喺 Art Basel 呢個 booth 去做啦。咁當時其實我本身已經做咗一啲可能係 GIF 圖啊，或者一啲 pixel art 嘅插畫咁樣。咁然後就諗可唔可以做一隻可能係短篇嘅遊戲，就主要喺個 booth 嘅最新嘅作品咁樣咯。咁如果 參加者嚟玩嘅時候咧，其實就係玩緊我呢個角色。咁個故事內容咧就係我係一個係未來嘅，係我係一個考古學家考古隊嘅隊長咁樣。咁我就同一啲隊員失散咗，我跌咗入一個洞穴入邊。 咁喺個洞穴入邊咧，就要搜尋四件作品。咁嗰四件作品就係我之前做嘅陶瓷作品嚟嘅，但係就轉換咗變成一個 pixel 嘅道具咁樣。嗰四件作品咧有對應唔同嘅能力，咁就幫助我脱離依個洞穴，就揾翻我嘅隊員，穿過一個傳送門咧，翻翻嚟阿巴蘇依個 booth 嘅現場咯。都想嚟參與嘅人可以有即係有種遊玩嘅感覺咯。平時如果你行一啲畫廊、商業畫廊或者藝術空間，好多時都係有一種好冰冷啊，或者同觀眾有一種疏離距離感噶嘛。即係特別喺一個咁商業嘅城市入邊，咁所以即係嘗試有種好似翻翻去 PS4 或者去一啲任天堂嘅試玩會嘅時候，其實佢都有一個展場。入面亦都有試玩嘅部分咯，咁我嘗試將嗰個空間嗰個氛圍就帶入嚟阿巴叔咁樣。
For their first jointly commissioned project, Art Basel and M Plus asked film and video artist Alan Powell to create a moving image work, The Shape of Light, on the visage of M Plus. In the site-specific work, Powell fuses live-action performance, sci-fi sequences.An animation to express the Heart Sutra Vasai language. In another commissioned work, Art Basel and the Hong Kong Tourism Board collaborate to put the work of three local artists on wheels by wrapping selected Hong Kong trams with paintings they have created.
我今次有一個合作係同 Art Basel 用咗電車嚟到去將一啲藝術家嘅作品放上去。咁我就揀咗我自己上年嘅一件作品，就係喺一個一本書上面係印咗北齋嗰個神奈川沖浪女嘅嗰張畫。咁喺上面咧，我就放咗一架天星小輪嘅模型喺上面，將佢營造到好似一個風景咁，就好似一架天星小輪行喺一個大浪裏邊。原本嗰個畫作咧。唔係好大張，咁而家係放到係一架電車咁大嘅時候咧，你會覺得特別係嗰個浪咧，其實嗰個震撼係大好多嘅，要有嗰種大浪好似冚埋嚟嘅嗰個效果咁樣。咁當架電車真係完成咗之後咧，佢係會 produce 一啲玩具，係 exactly 同嗰架電車一樣嘅一件玩具咯。咁我自己平時有一啲系列係。會用一啲玩具車嚟到去幻想一個風景嘅，咁於是我就覺得可以再做多一件作品係 specific for 今次呢一個 art tram 嘅，咁就係我背後嘅呢一件作品啦。
今年係第一次參展 Art Basel 啦，而且係可以展出一個新嘅系列，咁係覺得好榮幸同埋好開心嘅。
咁我呢一個新系列咧嘅主角咧，就係以一啲香港常見嘅雀鳥為一個重要嘅元素去畫呢個作品嘅。咁裡面亦都有一啲係香港可能懷舊嘅一啲紙皮石咁樣嘅pattern 啦，同埋一啲我哋細個嘅時候會成日玩嘅一啲玩具。呢一個系列嘅出現其實好大程度上係因為住喺我 studio 外面嘅兩隻麻雀仔嘅，佢哋每日就大概可能六點幾翻嚟，咁我就慢慢就發現其實我哋喺香港，我哋呢個城市有好多唔同種類嘅雀鳥嘅。當知道呢個作品會成為咗電色外貌嘅時候咧，我用 Photoshop 去將雀仔啦，或者裡面一啲玩具元素同埋一啲紙皮石嘅 pattern 各樣嘢勾線咁樣勾翻出嚟，跟住再利用電腦去編排佢嘅位置。因為我由細到大都係住喺新界地區，即係細個嘅時候，譬如會同爹哋媽咪啦，或者同朋友去港島搭電車嘅時候，對我嚟講就會係一種好似喺呢個城市做一個小旅行嘅感覺咯。
通常電車嗰啲廣告都係放啲明星啊，又或者係廣告 product 會多啲啦。好榮幸啦，可以參與到呢一個嘅。project 啦，就可以等大家認識一下香港做藝術嘅人，或者佢哋做緊嘅創作到底係點樣嘅形式嘅咧？咁我就畫咗個大山之餘咧，下邊就 放咗一架細嘅船啦，北宋時期嘅山水作品啦，好多時都係以一種巨碑式嘅山水去到做呈現嘅。咁嗰陣時咧就會係一座大山放咗喺一張畫嘅中間，就好似一個好巨大嘅存在咁樣樣，就將底下嘅人物啊，又或者屋仔啊，將佢都顯得好細微咁樣樣咯。咁如果係你留心啲留意嘅話，或者你又留意香港嘅船嘅話咧，就會發覺嗰架船其實係一架由北角去到觀塘嘅一架街渡嚟嘅。電車嘅感覺都幾特別嘅，因為咧我自己就好中意搭船啊，同埋中意一啲慢啲嘅交通工具啦。咁船以外咧就會係電車咯。Thank you.